Welcome to The Snapshot, our series which examines the forces shaping and driving global commodities markets today. The June 2nd OPEC meeting in Vienna ended with no agreement to restrict output, raising questions about whether the organization will ever return to output ceilings and quotas. Following his first OPEC meeting as head of the Saudi Arabian delegation, Oil Minister Khalid Al-Falah said that the market is rebalancing and imposing production cuts would be counterproductive. He added that settling a ceiling that the market would not respect was no way to demonstrate the value of OPEC. Delegates were optimistic afterwards, in stark contrast to recent meetings where low prices and divergent opinions have caused friction. Undoubtedly, this renewed optimism is to some extent due to the significant recent price recovery. Also on a positive note, OPEC has two key new personalities in Falah, who was well received at this meeting, and newly elected Secretary General Mohamed Barkindo. The Nigerian candidate called for unity within the group following his election, which marked a breakthrough after repeated extensions to Abdallah al-Badri's tenure as members failed to agree to a new Secretary General. Gabon's application to rejoin, which was approved at the meeting, also indicated the organization remains attractive to producing countries. The only dissenting voice following the meeting was that of Iranian Oil Minister Bijan Zanganeh. Characteristically belligerent, he repeatedly voiced his support for country quotas, commenting that OPEC is nothing without them, and their reintroduction at some point is inevitable. But even he seemed more upbeat than in the recent past, as he implied OPEC had accepted Iran's need to ramp up outputs. In the wake of the meeting, the battle for market share shows no signs of abating. Falah did say that Saudi Arabia will take a gentle approach, however, and is not planning to flood the market. OPEC will also be keeping a close eye on non-OPEC production, which it expects to drop by 740,000 barrels per day in 2016, as producers scale back production and postpone high-cost projects due to low prices. Since prices began a sharp descent in late 2014, OPEC members have significantly increased their discussions with key non-OPEC producers, most notably Russia. Qatari Minister Mohammed Al-Sada went on to Moscow after the meeting, but there have been no signs that another OPEC, non-OPEC producer meeting is on the cards. This is largely due to the price recovery that has made many producers believe that coordinated action is no longer necessary. But of course, all that could change before OPEC meets again on November 30th. Until next time on The Snapshot, we'll be keeping an eye on the markets.